Well, another edition of Rock the Talk, and with me I have a very special guest, and he is a very well-known metal guitarist, and he's also been a part of a rock band right here in India, and he's also a very, very well-known author now because he's released a new book. Hey, Sidharth, welcome to indigomusic.com.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
Sidharth, we'll talk about your book. You've ventured into a new arena, I would say, or a new new side of things, which is being an author. But before anything else, talk to me about, you know, your musical journey. Where did it all begin?
Okay, so starting from my college days, you know, where I actually wanted to pursue my career in the armed forces, and I appeared for the NDA twice and I couldn't clear it because those exams were damn difficult.
Right.
And then later on, I applied for IMA and got through. But then, my family wasn't too keen on letting me join the infantry. So I was like, okay, then if not that, then something else, because I was definitely not a guy who would like to sit in front of a desk from 9 to 5.
Right.
And so then, while I was almost passing out from college, I decided to let go of all my worries and, a little stressed out that, okay, I couldn't get into something that I actually wanted to do. So that's where I picked up the guitar and, I found a great teacher and, things picked up really fast from there. And, with nothing to do during our time back then, there was no cell phone, no social media.
Right.
So our only friend was, our CDs and cassettes and my guitar. So I would spend hours listening to music and trying to imitate that kind of sound on my acoustic guitar. And that's where the interest became into a passion. Passion became into a serious commitment.
Right.
And then ended up finding my band members, entered a few college competitions. And that's where, suddenly when you see you're playing decent college competitions and then, you are reaching the grand finale, playing to a bigger audience.
Right.
And then it all started taking a different route, and I started thoroughly enjoying the process of making my own music and playing it to an audience. And and when they reciprocate and respond to your composition, it's the best feeling. So
right.
Then to get better at it, I decided probably I should invest my time and effort in studying music professionally. So I applied in a contemporary college of music in LA, it's called as Musicians Institute.
Yeah,
so I did the 1 year performance degree program over there, met a bunch of fantastic musicians, great guidance, amazing teachers. And when I came back, then the rest is history. Just focusing on teaching and playing music, and it's just been that.
Right. Right now, you primarily, your genre of music, I would say, would be heavy metal. Now, which band is your biggest inspiration?
I mean, if there was one, then I could pick one right away.
Right.
But there are plenty,
But on top of the list, who tops the list?
I mean, there would be three on number
right.
one. Pantera is definitely one of them because I really admire that band because they are way ahead of time. I mean, because they are not around because both the brothers passed away. Then Sepultura, definitely, because they have this very raw tribal sound and they are not ashamed of infusing their cultural elements. They're from Brazil, so you can make out that they're a Brazilian metal band. And then this band that was shaping a different sound altogether, the world was not ready for it 20 years back. But today, 60% of musicians are inspired by them because they are way ahead of the curve. That band is Meshuga and they are from Sweden.
Right.
So some intricate stuff. So, three different styles. One is from America, one is from Brazil, one is from Sweden. So
yeah.
Various cultural infusions.
And also a lot of bands in India as well, they're really, really good when it comes to, the genre of heavy metal. Now, moving on from that to your brand new book that was launched on March 27th, if I'm not wrong. And it's called The Guitar Journal, Volume 1.
That's
What is this book all about? And what made you write this book, first of all?
Okay, so just a small prequel to this book. I am also an academic consultant for an examination board that's right. been in India for over 100 years. Trinity College London, that's a music examination board.
Right.
So my job as a consultant is to conduct teacher support training programs, like, you know, helping the teachers understand the examination syllabus, preparing them on how to prepare their students, clearing their doubts, and, you know, performing certain parts if it's a little complex at various levels, right from the right. foundation to your advanced level.
Right.
So for the past 7 years, I've been traveling across India, hosting and conducting these workshops for Trinity.
Right.
And most of the teachers, you know, who live in two or three tier cities, unfortunately, there is lack of awareness. There are quite a lot of challenges. They don't have the best support over there. So, you know, most of their questions would revolve around the same thing that, you know, okay, if this is not a teaching syllabus, then what do we refer to? What is right. our basic platform that we can refer to so that, you know, they are ready for any sort of competitive exams that are currently available in India and worldwide. Knowing the challenge, I decided to compile everything and put it in one form. Like, you know, if somebody wants to appear for whatever exam, just spend 3 to 6 months going through this book thoroughly. And, you know, you'll cover all the topics that you need to cover. And considering in today's time, you know, video content, I mean, it's infinite. YouTube is like a gigantic sea.
Right.
People tend to get lost. You know, they tend to lose out on their drive because they're not channelized or they're not finding the right guidance or, like, you know, the right steps that they need to take.
Right.
So even if they have this book and if they're referring to any sort of video tutorials, you know, this is a definitive guide that will take them step by step. So
right.
if you're a self-learner, if you have a teacher, if you're a teacher yourself who would like to use this as a textbook for your students so that you have an approach so that it's easier for you to assign work and tasks. That was my answer to everyone's question.
Right.
You know, giving
right.
it back to the community.
And where can one buy this book if they're interested?
So this book is available on Amazon as right. well as Pustak Mandi. I mean, people can just log on, type in the name and, you know, they'll get the link.
Right. Fantastic. Sidharth, it was absolute pleasure talking to you. And we'll connect soon when Volume 2 is out, because I'm guessing you wouldn't have put Volume 1 without having Volume 2 in mind.
Correct. Yeah, it's already there. I just have to sit and, like, you know, trim it and groom it. So basically
right.
sit down with my designer and polish it a little bit and see how I can do some things a little bit more different and probably, like, you know, up to date.
Right.
In the sense, how I can try and reflect modern technology so that, you know, learning becomes a lot more fun and, you know, it involves your attention 100%.
Right. Right. And we will connect once again when that book launches. All the best, Sidharth. And it was
an
absolute
so much.
Pleasure having you here.
Likewise. Thank you for having me.